Welcome, welcome. Thank you for coming. Thank you for joining. God bless you so much. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, we come before you, before your presence, God. We want to thank you this morning. I want to thank you and bless your name and give you all the glory, God. Loving Father, I honor you. Loving Father, I acknowledge your name. I thank you, God, my Father, in the name of Jesus. As I come before your presence, Lord, to thank you and to give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I commit your people into your hand, God. I pray for everyone that is joining us, even those who are coming to join us. I welcome them, God. I bleed the blood of Jesus. I cover myself with the blood of Jesus. I cover each and every one of us with the blood of Jesus. I cover Periscope with the blood of Jesus. I cover my scope with the blood of Jesus. Blood of Jesus, I soak everyone with the blood of Jesus. My Father and my God, in the name of Jesus, I want to thank you, Father. I give you all the glory and the honor in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. I want to welcome once again. Thank you for coming. Invite your followers. Invite your friends. Share this scope. Share to your friends. Welcome once again. Thank you so much. Hi, hi. Hi, how are you? Thank you for joining. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I'm going to talk to you the subject called prophetic prayer to possess the gates and doors of the enemies. I'm going to talk the subject called prophetic prayer to possess the gates and doors of the enemies. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to read from the book of Genesis. The book of Genesis 22, verse 17. The book of Genesis 22, verse 17. The Bible says that in blessing, I will bless you. And in multiplying, I will multiply your seeds. And as the stars of heaven, and as the sand which is on the sea, so, and your seed shall possess the gates of his enemy. Let me read again. That in blessing, I will bless you. And in multiplying, I will multiply you, your seeds, as the stars of the heaven, and as the sand which is on the sea, so, and your seed shall possess the gates of his enemy. Our Father in heaven, he promised our forefathers, he will bless them. And extended to his seed. We are the seed of our forefathers. We are the seed of Abraham. We are the seed. We have been adopted to the kingdom of God. We have been adopted to the seed of Abraham. We have been adopted to the seed of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Therefore, you have been given power and authority to possess the gates of the enemies. You know, the enemies, they are there. The enemies are there. They have built the gates so that you don't enter. They have built the gates. They have made sure that you cannot enter in these gates. They have made sure that there is nothing which could come from you. That's why the Bible says, from Genesis, from the beginning, from the book of the beginning, that your seeds will possess the gates of the enemy. Here is the book of 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians 16. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. 1 Corinthians 16, verse 9. First Corinthians 16, verse 9. The Bible says, for a great and effective door is opened unto me, and there are many adversaries. Paul is saying, the great doors and effective, great and effective door is opened unto me, and there are many adversaries. Great doors, God has opened great doors. But the enemies, devil, he saw that the door that God has opened to you. And then he went with his agent, with his witchcraft, with everything to close the gates, to close the door that God has opened for you, to put a gate on your way. Now this gate, the enemy has put on your way that you cannot pass. Because the door has been opened, a big door has been opened. So when the gate is closed over you, you can't go inside that door. Because the enemy has standing on that door. I am praying according to the book of Genesis. You have to know how to prophesy. You know how to speak prophetic word to your life, to your spirit. You prophesy and speak live word to you. Because God has said that you will possess the gates of the enemies. Therefore, every gates of the enemy blocking you to enter to your blessings, let this gate catch fire. Let this gate be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Any power standing at your door, closing your door of your blessings, let this door be destroyed in the name of Jesus. That's why many people, they have gifts. They have special gift, very unique gift, but the enemy is standing at the door, cannot let you to go and do the work God has called you. Welcome from Turkey. You see, the door has been opened. Look at this. Paul saw the big door has been opened for him to preach the gospel, but he was hindered by the enemies. The enemy has stand in the door. He is fighting you from entering into the door that God has opened. God has given has opened a big door for you. God has opened a big door for you. Therefore, children of God, I am prophesying to you, prophetically prophesying to you. Any door enemy has closed for you, I pray that God will open. Your door has been opened. Your door has been opened. Your gates has been destroyed because the Bible says you will possess the gates of the enemy. Any gate enemy is building against you, it has been bring down, it has been destroyed, it has been broken into pieces in the mighty name of Jesus. I have seen you, many of you, all over the world. Your big door has been opened for you. But the enemy who has been hindering this door has been destroyed in Jesus' name. The job you have been looking for this time, the enemy that has been holding your job, he has been destroyed in the name of Jesus. The financial problem you have been facing, you have been struggling you very hard to get even the water to drink. It is the gates of the enemy that has been built that you cannot able to get anything. That's why you have very difficult finances problem. Therefore, today, God has broken into pieces. You shall go and get what God has prepared for you, because he has a good plan for you. Big doors has been opened. Go and get it. It is yours. Receive these big doors in the mighty name of Jesus. Welcome. Thank you. Good morning to you. Look at this. Jesus, the Son of the living God, told Peter, hear the word of God. I am giving you power. Look at that. In Matthew 16, verse 18, the Bible says, and I say also to you that you are Peter. Say you are a Christian. Say you are a Christian. On this rock, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Calls Sabras. Call God. It will not. The gates of hell will not take it. Says the Lord. Call your name. Gates of hell has been taking everything you have. You are the church, not the building. Not the building that you are seeing. You yourself, you are a church. Therefore, God has given you, has built you. God has built a lock in you that the gates of hell shall not prevail against you. No more gates of hell shall take your blessings. No more gates of hell will take your blessings. Remember, from the beginning, you will possess the gates of your enemies. Therefore, every gate that has been built in your life, you will possess it. Because Jesus himself has given you power, has built the rock, that no powers of hell, no gates of the devil, no gates of witchcraft shall prevail against your presence in Jesus' name. You have to call your name. You see, say that you, Christine, and on this today, on this body, here, on your body, you call your body, because your body is the temple of God. If you have no idea, your body is the church, not the building. We are talking about your church, your body. Now, when Jesus told Peter that on this rock I will build my church. Now, when God built a church in Peter, you see what happened to Peter. Peter became very powerful at the end. Peter was able to preach within one day, 3,000 people got saved because he built a lock that would never change. The church that Jesus built in Peter, no powers of hell would take it. They tried, but they didn't take it. Like you, the church that God has built in you, no more witchcraft will get you and take it. No more powers of darkness will come and take it in the name of Jesus. No more enemies will take any blessings that that God has given to you. You have to know that you've been built a very strong foundation that no gates of hell shall prevail against you. Even this is a prophetic message, by the way. I am praying that God Almighty, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, no demon from the pit of hell will stand against you to claim your blessings. That is what it means. The Bible says, no weapon formed against you shall prevail. But the weapon of the devil has been prevailing against you. Jesus has said, no demon from the hell will prevail against you. No powers of darkness will prevail against you. In the mighty name of Jesus. When you look at this, you connect these scriptures, you will have your peace. You will stand firm and claim your possession. You will take the gates of the enemies. You will possess the gates of enemies. You will go to the gates of enemy and claim everything the enemy has taken from you. Because God has opened doors for you. God has opened doors for you. But the enemy, who is the devil, the Satan, has claiming your blessings every time. I am praying that God will destroy every gates of the devil, every door that enemy has closed for you. I pray that God will destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's look in the book of Isaiah 1 verse 1 to 7. Isaiah chapter 1 verse 1 to 7. The Bible says, thus says the Lord to his anointed Sabras, whose right hand I have holden, to subdue nations before him, and I will loose the locks of kings, to open before him the two-leaved gates, and the gates shall not shut. The door, the gates shall not shut for you. The God is saying that you will subdue. You are a ruler. You will rule. The gates shall never be shut over you. The gates that enemy has been shutting, that has been closing for you, it will never be closed. It will never be shut in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. You see, the Bible says, I will go before thee and make the crooked place straight. I will break in pieces the gates of bruce and cut in sunder the paths of iron. The Lord is going to destroy every crooked ways, every crooked gates, everything that is working against you. The Almighty God is going to destroy them, is going to make sure that every crooked ways, every corruption, or whatever has been working against you, the Lord is going himself to cut them in pieces. God is going to cut those gates in the name of Jesus. The month of September is the month of labor, is the month of giving birth to good things. All these gates that has been closed over you, the Lord is going to break them into pieces in the mighty name of Jesus, because he has opened the door. It is you to push it out and bring a baby out. Your vision has come and has come to pass. You've been having a lot of vision. You've been having a lot of ideas, but you don't know what to do about it. It is your time. Your vision, it is coming out now in the mighty name of Jesus. You have been planning to do this and this, but you don't know what to do. The Lord has break every gate, every satanic gate that has been holding your career, that has been holding your vision. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord has break to pieces every gate that has been holding your vision, every gate that has been holding your ideas, that you cannot achieve anything. You will achieve your vision. You will achieve every plans that you have been planning. Everything you have been planning this month is a month that you will achieve them in the mighty name of Jesus. You are going to get things that you've been planning. Your vision is going to come through. Your dreams is going to burst in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray, because I see people with big, big dreams, with big vision, but they have not do anything without. Because the gates was standing on their way, they can't pass. Now the gates has been destroyed. The Lord told me to tell you, the gates of hell has been closed, has been cut into pieces. Therefore, you have to go through. The door has been opened to you. Now you go through straight. Yesterday, I was praying for a woman. The woman came to see me. When I prayed for the woman, because her gates has been break down, her doors is open. Immediately, before even I started praying, I saw the angels, the fire from heaven, come down. I saw the angels coming and fighting and cutting to pieces all the demons, every works of which, everything that was there. I saw the angels, the place was shaken. I said, my sister, what is this? Do you hear? Do you see what is going on? The place was shaken like this. Then I said, maybe it's an earthquake or what it is. Because the gates has been cut into pieces. Because the gates has been destroyed. Now your gates has been destroyed. Your gates, God has cut your gates into pieces. This is what the Bible says. Look at verse 2. Isaiah chapter 1 verse 2. Let me look at this scripture again. Jesus. Isaiah 45. Isaiah 45, not Isaiah 1. Yes, it is typing hell as when I was typing. It should be Isaiah 45, verse 1 to 2. I'm going to see Isaiah 45, verse 1 to 7. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. My God, I want to bless your name. I thank you once again, Jesus. You are wonderful. Yes, thank you, Jesus. My God, I want to bless your name. Yes, it is as Isaiah 45, not Isaiah 1. It was typing errors. When I was typing, I think I made mistakes, and I didn't. The Holy Spirit has just reminded me. Not Isaiah 1, Isaiah 45, verse 1 to 7. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. God is God. In the name of Jesus. Yes, I want to thank God. In the name of Jesus. Look, you see Isaiah 45 verse 2. Let me bring the Bible. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, God, you are so good. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Isaiah 45, verse 2, it says, I will go before thee and make the crooked places straight. I will break in pieces the gates of brass and cut in asunder the bars of iron. The Lord is going to break to pieces the gates of brass, the gates of the enemy, the gates of the powers of darkness, the gates of witchcraft that has been standing against you in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, God. Holy Spirit, thank you for reminding me this scripture. Thank you, Holy Spirit. By the power in the blood of Jesus, I pray that God will destroy every gates of witchcraft, every gates of the enemy, every gates of the devil. The Almighty God is going to break them in pieces. The gates that has been standing against you, that you cannot do anything, that you cannot achieve anything, that you cannot go to your dreams in the mighty name of Jesus. I prophesy to you, by the power and the blood of Jesus, you will achieve, you will succeed, you will go and do the vision that God has made to you. You have big vision. Many years, you've been dreaming to do this and this, but because you have never achieved anything, you get discouraged, you get frustration. But today, that gate that has been blocking your ways, that gate that has been standing against you, that you cannot be go, you cannot go through, it has been broken into pieces. God has cut them into pieces in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, God, you are so good. I thank God that God is able. God is able. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you, Jesus. Lord, I bless your name. Jesus, I worship you. Let's look at the scripture, verse 3. The Bible says, and I will give thee the treasure of darkness and hidden riches of secret places, that thou may know that I, the Lord, which call thee by the name, I am the God of Israel. Now, when the gates of the enemy is being broken, it's been broken down. The Lord is going to give you a treasure. Hidden treasure. The Lord is going to bless you with money. The money that nobody knows. The Lord is going to make your vision to come through. The Lord is going to bring you money from the darkness, hidden riches. You know there's darkness. There's darkness and hidden riches of sacred places. Nobody knows. God will give you idea. Nobody knows this idea. And it is going to bring you money. The idea that God is going to give you, it is a sacred idea that will bring you money. God is going to release idea, a sacred idea that will bring you money. Look at that scripture. Verse 3. When the gates of hell has been destroyed, when the gates of the enemy has been destroyed, the Lord Almighty is now going to give you the treasures, the money that nobody knows. You will start the business because it's the hand of God, and this business will be blessed, will be blowing. Customers will come from all over. You will start a ministry. The ministry will be blessed. The ministry will grow. Your business will grow big. From a kiosk, from a store where you are, to the big, you become our sellers. That is the blessings of God. When the gates has been destroyed, look at that. Look at Isaiah 45, what God is saying. God is going to destroy every gate that has been standing against you. The gates of hell shall not prevail against you. You are a Christian, and God has promised that the gates of hell shall not prevail. You know the gates of hell? It's the gates of witchcraft. It's the gate of occult. It's the gate of envious. It's the gate of frustration. It's the gate of discouragement. That gate that discourage you. It is the gate that make you give up. It is the gate that make you to get discouraged. Therefore, understand today that the Lord Almighty will destroy every crooked ways. He will make straight in the name of Jesus. He will cut every gate of hell that has been working against your life, that has making your life miserable, in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, God, thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus. God, I thank you. Jesus, I give you all the glory, in the mighty name of Jesus. God is good. All the evil people in your life, God is going to destroy them. God is going to remove them in the mighty name of Jesus. All satanic people that the gates of hell has released for you, they are going to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. All the unfriendly friends that the gates of hell has released to you, it is going to be destroyed. All the husband, the wife, the wicked power, the gates of hell has released for you, God is going to destroy them in Jesus' name. God is going to cut them into pieces. You've been having evil friends. You never have good friends. All your friends are crooked. All your friends are evil. No one is good to you because gates of hell is the one released them to you. You always get bad people. You never get good people. Every time you want to post a person, every time you want to get married, you want to do something, the gates of hell bless you, evil people, even bad business, even bad jobs. You are not allowed to go to do these jobs, but because gates of hell have released it to you, and you take it, because they are the gates of hell. Now, when you take that job, hell will rise up, and they will fight you. They will fight you to make you miserable. Because of the gates of hell will go and connect you with a woman, with a wife. You marry this wife. When you marry this wife, problem will come that nobody will help you. And they will say, we told you, you marry a woman, and look at this woman, what is doing. Since you marry this woman, this is what is happening in this home. When the gates of hell give you a husband, your life will be destroyed completely. This is how the gates of hell is very dangerous. That's why you need to know how to deal with the gates of hell. That's why Jesus, God says you will take them. Because if you don't take the gates of hell, nothing good will happen to you. There are some false prophets anointed with the gates of hell. Their work is to curse. They will never say anything good. If even something literal happened, they have no mercy. They curse straight away. They curse you. They curse they put curses over people. Now, because the Bible has said you will take their gates, now every gates of satanic prophet, every gates of satanic pastors, every gates of evil people around you, they put a curse on you. The Lord has cut them into pieces. The Lord has break them into pieces. The Lord has destroyed them according to the word of God from the book of Isaiah. Has destroyed them and make the straight and make the path straight in Jesus' name. God is going to release treasure. God is going to release hidden riches of the sacred places. That you may know that I, the Lord, which called them by the name, I am the God of Israel. You will know that God is God. God has not refused to bless you. God has hidden treasure. God has hidden riches. God has hidden riches that he will release to you. God has hidden riches that is going to release you, and you will possess it because you will possess the gates of your enemies. All those riches that God has hidden for you, it belongs to you. Remember, The Bible says from the book of the beginning, God is going to bless you and multiply you. So people of God, hear the word of God. This is the word of God, that the Lord Almighty is going to release the blessings, the riches that nobody knows. When you start getting rich, people will say you went to eliminator to get it, or you went to a cult to get it, because you are going to be super rich. You will never be poor again. God has cut the gates of hell. God has destroyed the gate. That's why I asked you yesterday to call me to pray for you. If you didn't call me, still you can call me. I will pray for you. I've been praying for people, many people have been calling all over the world. I've been praying for them and prophesied to them. The gates of hell must come down from your life so that you can get your breakthrough. It is a real thing. If you have no idea, the truth is that there is gates of hell that will block you from prospering, from doing anything. Because they give the enemy, they give witchcraft power. This gate of hell, they work with the witchcraft, they work with the cult, they work with the evil people. That's why you see hell turn against you. Things turn up and down. Things change. You wonder, I am in the church, I am praying, I'm doing everything, but why is it that I am suffering like this? Why like this, God? Because gates of hell is operating in your life, and that's why nothing is working for you. When the gates of hell be destroyed in your life, you will see your breakthrough in the mighty name of Jesus. Look at this scripture. Yes, Lord, thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you. I thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I bless your name. Hallelujah. Now the computer is freezing. Yes, I don't care. We're still going on. Life will continue. I have the Bible here. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. The enemy is so jealous. When he wants to hear people are blessed, when the heaven is going to release the blessings, he's so jealous, he tried to attack everything. But in the mighty name of Jesus, he will be destroyed in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. Yes. Says, for Jacob my servant's sake, and I and Israel my elect, I have even called thee by thy name. I have surnamed thee. Although thou hast not known me, I am the Lord, and there is none else. There is no God beside me. I grant thee, although thou hast not known me, that thou may know from the rising of the sun and from the west that there is none beside me. I am the Lord, and there is none else. God is saying, is the Lord, is God. There is no one else. He is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He is the God who is going to release your blessings. He is God who is going to release his hidden treasure. Claim this. Declare this, verse 3, prophetically, that God is going to release treasure, hidden treasure. And you will receive money. You will receive riches. You will receive financial breakthrough in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says, and because God has said there is no any other beside God. There is no any other beside God. It is only Him, and it is Him alone. No one is like God. No one is like God of Jeshurun. No one is God like God of Abraham. No one is God of Elijah. No one is like God of our Lord Jesus Christ. No one is like our God, the Creator, who is in heaven. That is what He has said. This is what God said, that no one is like me, no one beside me. When I said, I have said that I will give thee the treasures of ever of darkness and hidden riches of sacred places, that thou may know that I, the Lord, which called thee by the name, I am the Lord of Israel. You will know that God is there. You've been sick, you've been suffering a lot. you will know that there is God in heaven. Today, God is going to furnish your sickness. Today, God is going to furnish your poverty. Today, God is going to furnish your rejection. Some of you, they have spirit of rejection. You were born from rejection straight away. Gates of rejection. The gates of darkness and rejection has been affecting you. That's why you cannot have friends. You can't do anything. When you get a friend, you talk to them nicely. 2 days, 1 month, 6 months, even 1 year. Then they disown you. They destroy you. They go away from your life. You wonder why? Because the gates of darkness, the gates of rejection, the gates of hell has been blinded against you. It is not your will. You have not done anything. But there is gates of darkness, gates of hell, that does not want you to have anything. But God, God of heaven, God of, who is God, God who is, there is no any other God like him, God of Israel, he is going to bless you. He is releasing the blessings coming to you. That's why you need to connect with me. You need to connect to our ministry. Go to our website, www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca, and donate. Donate an amount, and you will see how God is going to open these sacred treasures. God is going to open a sacred, hidden riches of sacred places for you. God is going to release the blessing that nobody has ever been blessed. You are going to hold money nobody has held in your family. You are going to hold money nobody, even the minister, even the president of the country, have never seen this money. You never know this, because look at that. If God is going to release his hidden treasures, his hidden riches of sacred places, nobody will have this money except you. Children of the devil, they have money. They are the richest people. Children of the devil, if you look at the world, you see the children of the devil, they are the ones who have a lot of money than the children of God. Why? Is God a liar? You would be the richest person in the world, not children of the devil, because God is going to release wealth to your hands. All the wealth of the Gentile, all the wealth of the wicked, all the wealth of those rich people, it is going to be transferred to your hands. I believe, I trust I will be the richest woman ever in the world. Forget about those women, you see them rich. I will overtake them, because I will take the gates of hell. You will overtake them. Don't worry about the ministry that is big, all the business. You will take it. You are going to take them. You are going to overtake them. You are going to build a big stores, big wholesale. You will own the business all over the world, because you are the child of the Most High God. God is going to give you the treasures of hidden riches of sacred places. God is going to release his wealth. Because he said, it is him who make you wealthy. Once the gates of, my dear friends, when the gates of hell has been destroyed, when the gates of hell has been destroyed, that has been broken your ways, you are going to achieve big things. Your big dreams is coming to pass in the mighty name of Jesus. Believe it, claim it, meditate this scripture, prophesize prophetically, receive it. This is what the God has said. It is as said, because every prophet must go with the scriptures, must align with the word of God. God is not a liar to say this scripture. This is the prophet Isaiah said so. So he understood how God works. You must know that God has sacred things that he wants to give to his children. He has been waiting until this day to release it for you. Now God is going to release them in the mighty name of Jesus. No power of darkness, no poverty will locate you. It has been destroyed. The gates of poverty that has been blocking you, it has been broken to pieces. Look at that, what the scripture says. Verse 2. I will break in pieces the gates of bars and cut in asunder the bars of iron. He's going to break them. The gates of poverty. The gates of poverty. The gates of poverty. God has set them fire. The fire of God has set them fire. No more gates of hell. No more gates of poverty in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, God, thank you, Father. Let's look in the book of Isaiah 60, verse 22. Isaiah 60, verse 22. Isaiah 60, verse 22. The Bible says, a little one shall become a thousand, and a small one a strong nation. I, the Lord, will hasten it in his time. You can see this. A little one shall become a thousand, and a small one and a small strong nation. I, the Lord, will hasten it in his time. A little one shall become a thousand, and a small one a strong nation. I, the Lord, will haste it in his time. You might be little. You might be little. Nobody recognizes you. Nobody knows you. But the Bible says you will become thousands. You will become big. You will be strong. Even if you are ministry small, even if you are small for now, you can say, I'm a small person. Nobody knows me. I can't do anything. Look at that. You may be little, but you will become a thousand. You will become strong. You will become big. You will become strong and strong in the name of Jesus. You may look at yourself and say, I'm a little person. I am nobody knows me. Nothing, nothing. You will become great and strong in the name of Jesus. Don't little yourself. Don't call yourself you are a small person. You are a little person. You are nothing. Don't call yourself names. Don't call yourself names. Look at it. A little one shall become a thousand. Little, because God is going to reveal the secret treasures that is in darkness. Nobody knows. God is going to release wealthy that nobody knows except the children of God. God has secret treasure is going to release for you. God has sacred money he wants to release to you. God has sacred plans he wants to give it to you. You may be small. Your ministry can be small, but it's going to become thousands. Your business can be small, but God is going to grow it to become thousands. And you may, because you've been small, that's why God is going to release you and make you thousands. You are going to make thousands. You are going to count thousands in your hands. You've been counting hundreds, but now, you are going to count thousands, up to millions, up to trillions. You are the child of God. This promise belongs to you. That's why I've come to you, to tell you that God has good plans. The gates of hell has been destroyed. Now you will grow in the mighty name of Jesus. You will become thousands. Your church may be small for now, but it's going to grow thousands. It's going to grow thousands upon thousands. That is the word of God. My pastor, my bishop, don't want the God has seen your church, has seen your cry. It's going to grow. You will grow. You may be retro now. You've been retro for many years, but your time has come when you will become thousands in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus. And a small one, a strong nation. I, the Lord, will hasten it in his time. It is your time. Now the church will grow. Your ministry will grow. Your business will grow. Anything you touch your hand is going to grow. The door has been opened for you. Go and enter. Go and receive it in the mighty name of Jesus. I thank God for this message. I pray that God would deliver you. And God has released blessings upon blessings in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let me pray that God will deliver every gate that has been assigned to you. The gates of blessings. You will possess the gates of your enemies. Enemies that has been taking your blessings. Now you are going to their gates and take them by force, by fire, in the mighty name of Jesus. You will possess the gates of your enemy. No more gates of enemy operating in your life. No more gates of hell will operate in your life, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, inject the battle aggression into your spirit. Let God inject you with a very fire and spirit, and go to the gates of hell, go to the gates of your enemy, and possess your possession, possess your money from there, in the mighty name of Jesus. Possess your blessings, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let God make you strength to go to the gate of hell and bring everything that the enemy has taken from you, in Jesus' name. Oh God, empower you. Let God empower you to possess the gates of your enemies. I pray that, oh God, let God empower you to possess the gates of your enemies, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let God empower you. Oh God, my Father, I pray, empower this person to go and possess the gates of hell, in the name of Jesus. To go and possess the gates of the enemies, in the mighty name of Jesus. My Father, my Father, my Father, my Father, I bring this person to you to empower him or her to go to the gates of the enemies and possess your possession. In the mighty name of Jesus. Go and possess your possession. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I uproot every evil altar in your life, in Jesus' name. I'm uprooting every evil gates. Every evil altar. Evil altar. Evil gates that has been building against you. I am uprooting them. In the mighty name of Jesus. The gates of hell shall not prevail against you. In the mighty name of Jesus. I destroy every gates of hell that prevail against you, in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, my Father, I call upon the word of God. I call upon you. The gates of hell shall not prevail, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You will possess the gates of your enemies, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let divine thunder scatter every meeting held against you at evil gates, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the divine thunder of God scatter every evil meeting held against you at an evil altars, an evil gates of the devil, an evil gates of the enemy, in the mighty name of Jesus. Every meeting that is held at evil gates of the enemy, let the thunder of God locate them and thunder them. Let the thunder of God thunder them, in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I bleed the blood of Jesus. I bleed the blood of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the divine thunder scatter every meeting held against your gates, against you, against the gates that is against your gates, in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Let the counsel of God for your life, let the counsel of God to for your life enforce you upon the enemies, in the name of Jesus. Let the counsel of God for your life be enforced upon the enemies, in the name of Jesus. Let counselors of God, let the counsel from heaven fall upon your enemies and destroy them, in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my God. I want to thank you, Jesus. Yes, my God, every chain used in holding you down for your progress, break and be destroyed, in the name of Jesus. I break them. I break every chain that has been holding you down for you to progress, I break them and destroy them in the name of Jesus. Every chain, every gate that has been holding you for you to progress, let them be break down and be destroyed in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, let them be destroyed. Every gate, every chain of gates that has been holding you down, that you cannot prosper, that has been holding down, that you cannot get what God has planned for you, let them be broken, let them be break down and be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Let them catch fire and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. Elijah has dealt with the prophet of Baal, and Jezebel threatened to kill him. This man has called down fire, fueled. Why? Because the word of Jezebel was packed up by evil powers. Jezebel had a gate, had evil gates. When he raised his gates, her gates, to go to Elijah, Elijah ran away for his life. But when Elijah remembered that his gates is powerful than the gates of Jezebel, he was crying and thinking, what can I do? Then the Lord reminded him, Elijah, what are you doing there? You forget the gates of fire that I have been giving you. Do you forget the fire that you have been calling? Why are you staying there? Come out, get away. Today God has been calling you. Maybe you have been running away because you don't know what to do. You've been running away from church to church, from prophet to prophet, from pastor to prophet. It's your time now to sit down and focus. Is this your time to settle down and enjoy the blessing that God has given to you? It is your time to sit down, and because you have been running so much, like Elijah who was running. Elijah who called fire from heaven and consumed the bar and consumed the witchcraft. When Jezebel raises her gates, Elijah has to run away. So you will not run away. You will stay. You will stand still. Because the gates of hell will not prevail against you. Remember what Jesus has given you. Jesus has promised you the gates of hell shall not prevail you. You will possess the gates of your enemies. Therefore, children of God, don't run away. Don't cry. Don't complain. Because crying, complaining, it cannot help you. You've been crying a lot. You've been complaining a lot. It is your time to possess the gates of your enemies. It is the time to possess the gates of your enemies. It is your time to sit down and focus, God, and possess the gates of your enemies. The Lord is concerned about you. The Lord loves you. He cares about you. It's only you. You have not decided what to do. I am giving you the materials that you will never get from churches. You know you have been following so many pastors, so many prophets, so many churches, but nothing you are getting from there. Start prostituting yourself. Stop scattering yourself. Focus in one thing. God will visit you. Because you go to everywhere, you get confused. When you hear this preaching this, when you go this, you find this. When you find a false prophet prophesizing, a false prophet is preaching somewhere, he feed you with his spirit. So you get confusion. Because he has seen what you have, then they take everything from you. Stand firm and stand still. You will receive the salvation of God. No more gates of hell shall control you, shall take your blessings. When Elijah was running away from Jezebel, from a witch, and remember, Elijah, he was the one who killed witchcraft, who was calling fire. Now, when the gates of hell raises against him, he ran away. Until God call him and tell him, Elijah, what are you doing there? Why are you learning? God is calling you today. Why are you learning? Why are you scattering yourself to everywhere? Why can't you focus in one place? I have so many videos. I have a lot of materials. Follow these materials. Call me. I will pray for you. I want to teach you. I want to help you. If you have been following so many pastors, you have been in big church, but your life is still the same. Try to sit down like God told Elijah. Why are you learning? What are you doing there? What are you doing there? When you see that God has destroyed the gates of hell, God has given you the gates of your enemies. You will possess the gate of enemy. Call me. I will pray with you. Our number is 647-608-5207. Once again, this is our cell phone. You can text me. You can call me from anywhere in the world. If you have your cell phone, you can always text me. And our landline is 905-487-7196. Our landline, 905-487-7196. God will bless you. If you need me to teach you, to help you, we have a school of deliverance and healing ministry. So if you want to become a deliverance minister and you want to know this deliverance subject, deliverance, call me. I will teach you. I will help you. We have our free line, toll free, is 877-241-3420. You can reach me this number. It's a free number. You can call if you are in Northern America. It is for Northern America people. 877-241-3420. Call me. I will help you. Go to our website, www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca. You will not miss our materials there. It is there, and the videos, it is about deliverance. It will teach you and help you. Remember, God says you will possess the gates of your enemies. Don't run away. God, Jesus said, you have been given, he has built you a rock. God, Jesus has built a lock in you. No gates of hell shall prevail. You don't have to go to look for a judge. You are a judge yourself. God has given you, has built a rock that nobody, no demon from hell, no witchcraft, that will make you to run away. No witchcraft will destroy you. No witches and wizards, no cult, no powers of darkness will destroy you. Believe the word of the Lord and you will prosper. This is the word from the prophet. You believe the word of the prophet, you will prosper. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every agent of spiritual and prosperity parasites, be dismantled in the mighty name of Jesus. I command every agent of spiritual and prosperity parasites, be dismantled now in the name of Jesus. Let your life be squeezed out of the dream attackers in the mighty name of Jesus. Every dream attackers, be squeezed. Let life be squeezed from dream attackers. Every satanic dream that has been torturing you, you've been dreaming the same dream. Let this dream be squeezed. Let life be squeezed from these dream attackers. Dream attackers, I prophesy to you that let life be squeezed from you, that you will never come to attack this person again. I am commanding them to die. Let life be squeezed from satanic attackers. Witchcraft attack in your dream, let life be squeezed from them in the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil covenant installment. You know there is a evil covenant that has been installed into your life against you. I command them to be disbanded, be destroyed, and rendered powerless in the name of Jesus. Oh God, arise with your power and destroy every gates of the enemy. Every gates of the enemy. Let God arise. Let God of Elijah arise with the fire and destroy and burn out every gates of your enemies in your life in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord. Yes, Jesus. I thank you, Father. I give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you. I have to stop here. I love you so much, and there's nothing I can do about it. These videos will come up today, so go and view it. Remember, God has promised you to take the gates of hell, to take the gates of the enemies, to possess the gates of enemies. enemies has possessed your possession. Therefore, it is your time to possess your possession. Possess your possession from the gates of the enemies in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you very much. Thank you. God bless you. Call me. I'm here to pray with you. I'm here to stand with you. You are not alone. Stop prostituting yourself. Stop wandering from place to place. You cannot get anything if you are not focused. That's why life is like that. Thank you very much. God bless you. See you tomorrow midnight. Tomorrow we are starting our midnight. We are going to pray tomorrow spiritual warfare midnight in the mighty name of Jesus. So join me midnight, 12 midnight. If you miss to join, the videos will be on. So go to our website, go to our YouTube. You will get the videos and the videos will help you. Thank you very much. God bless you. I love you so much. There's nothing I can do about it. Amen. Thank you so much. Bye.